Hey guys, it's Postbox Pam. Welcome back to a brand new news video. And in today's video, we've got so many topics to go over for you guys. Let's get straight into this and go over what we've got. So first off, we're gonna be starting off with the brand new Loki skin announcement. If you guys are new around here, then don't forget to tap that subscribe. As always, it really does go a long way and help support the channel. But Fortnite earlier today did release this on their group. I already put this on my community post, but I just thought I'd give it another mention. So basically, it seems that Mecha Cuddle Team Leader wasn't the only one who found their way to the island. Looks like the Trickster snuck his way through the portal and into the Fortnite crew this July. This is obviously hinting towards Loki with a collaboration with the new series on Disney Plus, so it's nice to see that Loki's going to have his own skin in the game, and I actually can't wait to see some more previews of this. I'm guessing we won't get a preview of this now until like maybe even like closer to July, maybe in the next few days, maybe even tomorrow, I don't know 100%, but we'll have to wait and see. I'm sure Fortnite might actually tease it. They usually do tease it a little bit early so people can buy it if they want it. So yeah, that's really nice. If you haven't purchased the Battle Pass yet, or have already purchased the Battle Pass using V-Bucks, if you do buy the Crew Pass, I believe you do get a full refund on your V-Bucks that you spent on the Battle Pass. That's what I've heard anyway. So if you are interested in the Loki skin, just buy the Crew Pass and you should get a bunch of V-Bucks back as well, which would be kind of nice if you want them. So yeah, good overview there for everyone in the community, kind of a hype one as well, and one that I'm kind of excited for overall. So let me know in the comments, guys, what you guys think about that. And yeah, in the background gameplay, we do have the Pro 100. This is because the new summer challenges are involved in this Pro 100. So if you're interested in grabbing the new summer challenges and the new summer rewards, it is in the Pro 100, which is really nice. So yeah, that's kind of cool, and I do kind of like that aspect as well. They are kind of implementing creative challenges into the Pro 100. You can see the free challenges here on screen. Obviously, these free challenges go as followed. You can see they're kind of nice. They're okay, I guess. They're not like perfect, but they give you a good overview of everything to get. Now, they're quite difficult to do, the revive one, because people do press respawn in this game mode, as well as the spending coins isn't too difficult, and also deal damage with a rocket isn't too difficult at all. But the revive one can be a little bit difficult, and maybe even the rocket one can be difficult for some if you can't manage to farm up enough coins. But remember, you can always do this with your friends in a private lobby, which is probably the best way if you really want to boost through these challenges as quickly as possible. So yeah, there's your overview of that. Now let's move on from the Pro 100 gameplay and we'll put in some other gameplay. The gameplay I've got playing for you guys right now is actually the gameplay I use for pretending to be Boss Brutus on my second channel. It's an awesome video, so if you get some free time, head over there, check it out. I think you would enjoy it if you like to see some bosses kind of acting and just kind of like trolling random people in game. It's a really fun video. Give it a watch after this. So let's move on to the next topic for you guys, because we've actually got a lot of stuff in today's video, and this one is actually coming in with an overview of kind of, I guess, some interesting stuff on the side of Battlestars. So if you're interested in not spending your Battlestars, which I don't know why you wouldn't be, but you never know, you might just not spend your Battlestars and you just might be someone that doesn't really care about spending them. And if that is you, your rewards should also redeem next season, according to Hypex. Again, I can't guarantee it. If it doesn't work, blame Hypex if you're one of them people. I'm sure there's probably like maybe one person out there that does this, maybe more people will. I don't know, it's a strange one. Okay, moving on to the next one, you can see the UFO as well is progressing even further now over the map. These pictures here show that the UFO is slowly rotating around to the right. We can assume in the next few days or so, the UFO will eventually get around to Coral and maybe even zap it. I'm guessing in the next 2 weeks, because Epic Games are on a 2 week break from Monday, so expect them back after that, which is probably why the update's probably not gonna drop now for another 3 to 4 weeks for the following update, which is okay, because they have a lot of content lined up in game, especially with the summer event stuff, and I've got a lot of special videos to work on for you guys, so there's a lot of stuff in the works. All right, moving on to the next one, we've got some really interesting stuff coming in with the actual, I guess, this stuff here. So this is kind of interesting. This is actually the Cowinator weapon. I don't know what this is going to be like, but we've got a lot of stuff on this, so let's go over what we have so far. Info for the upcoming Cowinator weapon, which could drop in the next 2 weeks possibly. It's also going to be 600 NPC and also the prop gun, unless that they scrap it, so that's possibly probably not what it's going to be, to be honest. It won't be the prop gun. I don't know, you'd be able to buy it from an NPC and also the prop gun. Maybe you will be able to buy the prop gun. Imagine that. You can lift players from your vehicle, big objects and some incompatible objects. I have no idea what this is on about here. Cowinator weapon, you can lift objects and throw them. Oh, this will be the one. I guess this is the one that Rick has. So this is going to be a really cool object. You can, really cool weapon, you can pick up objects and throw them. I think this is going to be sick, but it looks like you have to buy it, so that's coming very, very soon. But speaking of that, there is something really interesting which is going around in the community, and that's actually this inflatable bull weapon. So yeah, this is really cool. This is actually a suit that gives you a cow-like properties, and we've got a bit of footage of this as well, such as being able to roll up hills, bounce off cliffs, and through fire as well, which is crazy. You know normal car stuff. So this is going to be a crazy item, probably added in towards the mid-season range, I'm guessing. And this weapon itself is going to come with a few different mechanics. You can see here, here's a little video of what it looks like in-game. Kind of cool as well. So I thought I'd put this in here, as well as a little picture of the overview of some of the different styles for this. So overall, this is just a great addition and something which everyone in the Fortnite community would like to use and try out. I think generally overall, I would love it as well. Let me in the comments what you guys would think about it. I don't know really what I think of this. I think it's quite cool. I think it's going to be fun for a little bit, and then after a while it's going to kind of become a useless item. But I think in game modes like battle labs and maybe even solos, it might be good for rotation actually. So who knows, and maybe if it's endless use, it'll definitely be good. It'll remind me of like the group ball, if you know what I mean. They are really getting creative with these weapons, and I think that's a great point. But I just feel like this item might just sit somewhere where no one really uses it after like the first 2 days or so, unless it's got a really good use for rotation. We'll have to wait and see obviously on that side of the stuff. Now speaking of item shops as well, with the 4th of July coming out, I believe this skin will be coming into the shop. You can see a little picture of it here, the Roman Candle, as well as I believe he's going to come possibly with a... not an inbuilt emote, like a separate emote. That's what people are saying anyway. Can't guarantee it though, guys. This separate emote should be coming with him. Here's a little bit of another screenshot of him right here. So I'm really excited for him. I generally think overall he's going to be a really good addition to the game, and a lot of people would like that. Also, this concept here coming in from Virakuro. I have no idea how you say the guy's name. Virakuro. You say he was actually someone that donated on the stream, so thank you Virk there for donating. I'm just going to call you for now Virik. Thank you so much. And yeah, the concept was actually a really cool one. So he basically said that you could have a crafting recipe for two pistols to turn them into a dual pistol, and I thought this was such a great idea. I seen it a while ago, he tweeted me, but I just forgot to put it in a video. So two blue ones would make blue dualies, and then obviously an upgrade would make a better one. So I think that's so cool, and just overall two pistols of the same rarity when crafted would make the dual, like the dualies, the same rarity. So yeah, that would be so sick. And I think overall this gives us use for the pistols when we find them. So great concept, and I hope Epic do implement this. This is a really good idea. Hope you guys like it as well down below in the video, so in the comment section. So let me know what you guys think. Next one we've got is this one coming in from Ark. So again, I'm going to reference something here. People sleeping on my storyline video. I've been mentioning how Kevin is being powered by IO, aliens, etc. Since the season, it was the Spire storyline video I made. I've been mentioning it for a very long time, but I really went in depth in that video explaining how IO have control of Kevin, but also the aliens are also harvesting the same energy. And again, Ark here kind of referencing that. I think a lot of people still are sleeping on that storyline video. I'm almost certain everyone here has watched it, but a lot of people just randomly getting recommended aren't clicking it, because I don't know why, but it literally just tells you the storyline. It's one of my best videos I've ever made. I'm still really proud of that video. I feel like I stand by that a lot and kind of go over the story and just everything behind that. So yeah, it's a great one, and generally it is worth checking out if you've got some free time. So that's a little reference there. And then finally in today's video, we have a reference to this. Fortnite accidentally added in the new item shop UI art, and he's a texture's name, code name Majesty, which is Majesty, sorry. And finally, we have Fortnite's new art they've added in for the background of item shops. So these will probably be getting put in later throughout the week and stuff for different kind of shops, which I really do like. These are like the background pictures in the item shop. So I think you guys should be excited for them. Let me know in the comments if you are or if you aren't. Other than that, that's everything for today's video. Don't forget to go and use code POSTBOXPAT in the item shop when Thanos does release tomorrow. We will be streaming that as well for you guys. You can get a full overview of when Thanos does get added to the game. Thank you so much. And once again, leave a like, comment, and subscribe. And this is POSTBOXPAT signing out.